I'm here with the Managing Director of ClearView Wealth, Simon Swanson, on the second day of the 2015 Macquarie Securities Australia Conference. Over the last few years, ClearView has grown its business both organically and through acquisitions. Simon, thanks for your time this morning.
My pleasure.
Talk me through what ClearView has delivered and what we can expect over the next 12 to 24 months.
Oh, the key highlights for us is we continue to make good progress on the rollout of our three J curves of investment. The first one being the life advice business, which started in 2012. The second one being Life Direct, which started in July 2013. And last October, we successfully launched our own platform for superannuation and investments. So we're very pleased with the progress on those three fronts, and we'll continue to invest in our organisation in the next few years, but not to the same degree that we've done in the past.
Can you give me a bit of an overview of the superannuation platform?
The superannuation platform is all done from model portfolios, so it's very efficient for advisors, and it's also very transparent for customers because you can actually look through and see the underlying fund managers on each of the model portfolios. It's efficient for advisors because it allows them to actually not have to do a statement of advice or a record of advice when there's a change in fund manager or a change in asset allocation.
And what will that mean for the business and its profitability moving forward?
Well, obviously we're only investing in it because it will increase our profit in the future. So obviously we expect to see growth in our wealth management profit in the future.
Now, over the past few years, the business has grown both organically and through acquisition. Can you talk me through what we can expect over the next 12 to 24 months?
Actually, our focus has always been on organic growth, and we actually continue to focus on that. Acquisitions will only come up if they make sense at the time. So acquisitions per se are not part of our strategy, and we'll continue to focus on organic growth.
And just finally, Simon, can you talk me through the likely impact of the various regulatory reviews that are currently taking place in the financial services sector?
Well, there's no lack of them, I can assure you of that. There's probably four components to it. The first one is the PJC inquiry in corporations and financial services, which is around advisor education, and we're particularly pro that. We think that's a good thing for the industry, and it's obviously good for ClearView too. The second one is the removal of narrow approved product lists for dealer groups. That obviously opens up a large market for ClearView, and we're quite excited about that one. The third one is actually the removal of volume bonuses and shelf space fees for dealer groups. That actually improves our access to the broader IFA market, so we're excited about that. Advisor remuneration is the last component. We actually think broadly that'll be good for us. We're just waiting to see the details as they come out there.
Well, excellent. Certainly sounds like it'll be an interesting few months ahead.
We will not be looking for things to do.
Thank you very much for your time today.
Thanks.